2 days ago, I was finishing up a frame for a painting I did as a wedding gift, wondering how in the world I'll ever find a platform to get collab out of my thoughts and into the minds of others. Then yesterday, a good friend emails me a link to a social entrepreneurship competition. And today, I'm sitting in front of a camera pitching it. Funny opportunity can sometimes present itself. I'm Rob Irwin. I live in sunny Denver, Colorado, a place geographically known for its progressive transitions and its grassroots movements. I graduated from the Art Institute of Colorado 7 years ago with a degree in industrial design. My grad project, which was a biomimetic wind turbine, was to be the boon unto which I was offered an internship at the prestigious Rocky Mountain Institute, where I designed carbon sequestration bioreactors and later reviewed lead submittals for the built environment. I've started 3 companies, all environmentally focused, one of which we developed an LCIA database for a client to instantaneously generate environmental impacts of large product orders. Another focused on social awareness and environmental issues through graphic design and apparel. And the latest is an industrial design firm specializing in design for prosperity by way of process, supply chain, materials, distribution, impact, and implication assessments. Through my design career, notably in the field of sustainability, the problem with social borders between different techniques and disciplines became more and more obvious when the solution to most all issues of creation could be solved through the lens of the generalist. That is to say, the borders between social capital and commerce lay a cooperative commerce that embraces the knowledge that this is where most new discoveries are made and most action is inaugurated. Ergo, collective laboratories, or CoLab for short. CoLab is what I'd like to think of as the ultimate idea in social entrepreneurship. It is a wellspring for anticipatory design science and social reconnection. CoLab is a collective attracting progressive, innovative, sustainably minded business leaders that nurture the connection of community through the cross-pollination of arts, ecology, design, education, music, and making it a destination spot and increasing quality of life for all. It is a solution to the disconnection of ideas to disciplines. The caveats to CoLab's existence lay in its beliefs, and its beliefs are these. Environmental education, implementation, create generationally adept and resilient communities. Corporate social responsibility creates market advantage and customer loyalty. Environmentally sound organizations display true human intention. Organizations are responsible for their existence and should regulate their ecological impacts. Organizations are responsible for their service and safety of their products, upstream and downstream waste. Organizations are responsible for protecting and propagating global biodiversity. Organizations are responsible for providing non-discriminatory, safe, healthy, and fair work environments for all. CoLab's business model revolves around the triple bottom line, but considers itself to be continuously evolving. The tools offered by CoLab allow local business owners to collectively engage customers, clients, and neighbors more efficiently from a single location and include physical storefront, shared multi-use space for open space programming, advertising and marketing exposure, shared fundraising opportunities, event hosting, free access to all events held on the grounds, a co-op workspace / studio, and an internally operated cafe bistro that sources seasonally from the permacultured edible garden in the back. Ultimately, CoLab can be boiled down to an approximation of equation. My idea for this probably stems from a bit of lead reviewing I've done in the past. CoLab will have 10% minimum property should be designated for growing edibles. This promotes organic growing, education, community interaction, and healthy living. 50% maximum to be used for building and structure. Engages urban density, promotes green spaces, shade, biodiversity, and reduces heat island. Maximum 5% parking designation for combustible vehicles. Promotes healthy forms of transportation, pollution reduction, noise reduction, increased safety, makes room for nature. 5% minimum for parking for non-combustible vehicles. This promotes alternative modes of transportation, health, and increases safety. 30% on average outdoor mixed-use space, which encourages diversity, meeting space, and serendipitous interaction. This is a rough model I did illustrating the layout of CoLab. You can see the geodesic performance stage in the background. Rotating left in the midground, we see what would be seasonally sourced cafe bistro. To the left, forefront retail on the first floor with startup commercial space on the second. There's second floor decking for views down onto the green space during outdoor events, a terraformed front lot to be used for seating during outdoor events, and the rear of the lot show an open space where the edibles garden would exist, and the other half dome represents space for an indoor grow house. All this sounds hard to come by if you didn't have it built from the ground up. As it turns out, I already have a location picked out and the lot is on the market. I can say that the timing is perfect too, because as a sustainability chair for the Five Points Business District Redevelopment, I was on the advisory team for the vision planning and know that the collab is a mirror to what people with Five Points wish to see in their neighborhood. So that's my pitch. Thanks for listening.